All right, it's finally happening. You asked enough. This is my how I got rid of my acne permanently and what I thought about Accutane chat. Ba-ding! I went on Twitter and asked you guys to ask me questions about Accutane and acne and my entire journey with all of that, and you delivered quite handily. This is a video that I've been wanting to do for a very long time. As you guys know, I did 6 months of Accutane last year, and it completely changed, honestly, my life. Like, I know that sounds so dramatic, but I struggled with acne for 10 years, like 10 solid years, my entire adolescence slash adulthood college years were just spent dealing with hormonal acne that wouldn't go away regardless of what I did to it. Like, I did Arden, y'all. Like, Arden. Let's just say I was pretty close to taking, like, every amount of Proactive I had bought over the last 10 years and putting it in the middle of a pentagram and lighting it on fire just to see if something might happen. That probably would have been an interesting experiment, and my mom would have really loved that in our living room. I did everything short of summoning a demon to sell my soul to get rid of my acne. That's what I'm trying to say. So I'm just gonna go through these questions kind of in a semi-chronological order, since you guys basically made this video by asking me wonderful questions. Thank you to everyone who sent me something on Twitter. I'm sorry I can't get back to all of you, but for those of you who make it in this video, congrats and thank you for your wonderful words. So the first question I'll answer kind of ties in with what I was just talking about. At what point did you feel that Accutane was the next step? Is it true you have to go to your doctors every month for a pregnancy test? And that's from at Here Comes Tessa, Tess the Mess. Thanks, Tess, you da best. I felt like Accutane was the next step for a rather long time, but I was just so anxious and nervous about the idea of going on such a harsh medication that I probably delayed the process of going on Accutane for like 5 years. I had had it recommended to me as early as high school, like when I was 17, going into 18. I remember someone, like a dermatologist I went to, being like, well, you know, like, typically, the thing that really sees a lot of results is Accutane. It's a bit harsh, it's a bit crazy, but like, that's kind of what works. And it seems like you've been on, oh, let's see here, 50 different medications, so none of that's working for you. Accutane was always something that I wanted to go on. I was just scared because it is something that's very daunting and it shouldn't be taken lightly. But also, I have a really crazy fear of doctors and medical situations, and I really didn't want to have to go get my blood done every month, which was something that I heard you had to do, and you definitely do. You do have to get your blood taken at least like 2 or 3 times. I think in total I got it taken 3 times. One of the things that I'm most thankful for Accutane for is that it did help me get over that medical phobia. Like, forcing myself to get my blood taken made me realize how not scary it actually is. Like, I used to be the type of person that you try to take me to the doctor and I would literally run away like screaming. Like, I used HEPA. I called HEPA on my dad so I didn't have to get a shot one time. So like, that is how severe my medical phobia is. I love my dad, I would not do that usually, but it's like a wild animal takes over. So to be able to just like quell that fear with the appropriate amount of medication and then get my blood drawn really helped me, and I feel so much better about going to the doctor. I knew that Accutane was always going to be the next step. I just didn't know when it was gonna happen. And to be honest, I wish I had done it like 5 years earlier, because it would have made my life so much easier. Like, I was even looking back through pictures for this video just to kind of like see what the last couple years looked like to me, and I could just tell. Like, I remember being in my body through all these like selfies I took and pictures I posted online, like how much my skin affected my mood every day, how much it affected like my daily life. The amount of like obsessive thoughts I had around it, because I already have a form of OCD or ICD called trichotillomania, but it's basically like an anxiety coping mechanism for me. And so like, that disordered thinking also would go into my skin. Like, I was so concerned with my skin all the time, and it would affect every aspect of my life. I was constantly trying to figure out, you know, what was causing it. Was it my diet? So, you know, I would cut out dairy, or I'd cut out sugar, or I'd, you know, I went vegan for a year just to see if it would make a difference in my skin, and it didn't. So, like, there were things like that where I would just, like, go whole hog trying to figure out what was wrong with my skin. I probably spent tens of thousands of dollars over the course of a decade trying to solve it, and the only thing that did it was Accutane for me. I was basically at my wit's end, and I was willing to do anything because I was so sick of, like, probably 15% of my daily brain going towards my skin, like wondering if anybody could see my acne, the pain of my cystic acne. My under the skin hormonal acne was so painful. Wondering if it was flaky or gross, or if like people, when I was meeting with them, would be less respectful of me because I had bad skin. Like, it's just, it takes over your life in a way that people without acne don't really get. But if you've been through it, you know, it's something that just, it occupies so much space in your brain. Like, I could not see myself as attractive. I always thought of myself as like that quirky, funny girl, but I never thought of myself as that attractive because of my acne. I just couldn't see past it, you know, and I didn't love myself the way that I could if I wasn't constantly worried about something on my face. And it sounds vapid and it sounds silly, but if you haven't been through it, it's hard to really describe that feeling. I knew it was the next step when I was just not leaving the house because of my skin, or I was saying no to social engagements because of my skin. I was like, this is taking over my life in a way that I can't control anymore, because I used to be able to quell that. But in the last couple years, I realized how much it actually actively affected me. So by that point, I was like, fuck it, take my bloods. Well, no, I actually, when I called the dermatologist to set the appointment to get my blood drawn, I burst into tears, like knowing what I had just put on the line, basically. And I know that, once again, it sounds so silly, but I was just so anxious about all of it. It just made me so nervous. So it was a big step for me, and I'm proud of myself for doing it. So there you go. That was when I knew it was the next step. And to answer the pregnancy test conversation, you do have to take pregnancy tests because isotretinoin, which is the ingredient that makes up Accutane, the chemical, it is really bad for fetal development. So yeah, you just have to make sure you're not pregnant on it, basically. Now, before we get too deep into this, I have to talk just for a second about something very exciting, which is that this video is sponsored by Audible. What? Audible? Is that even, what even is that company? I've never heard about it on the internet before, not especially on YouTube ever. Audible is doing something super cool. It's basically like an initiative to help you reach your New Year's resolutions. So if you finish 3 audiobooks by March 3rd, so that's 3 audiobooks by 3/3, if that makes sense, and you get $20 of Amazon credit. Like, what? You're basically getting money for listening to audiobooks and finishing audiobooks, which is kind of dope and awesome. Audible is going to keep track of it all for you, so you don't have to like let them know when you finish 3 audiobooks. It'll be able to tell by your account. If you need an audiobook recommendation, I would definitely check out Selfie by Will Storr. It's a really interesting audiobook because it's sort of breaking down why our generation, or why this generation of humanity, is sort of in a self-obsessed bubble, why it's kind of the I generation and not the we generation. It's very, very interesting, and it also kind of helps you figure out where you fall on the like narcissism spectrum, but also how you can combat that to live a happier life. So very, very cool. It's definitely more of a scientific look at all of it, which is very helpful to me. I like that. So definitely check it out. Definitely give it a listen. It is a good one. So if you want to, you can go to audible.com/ardenrose or text ardenrose to 500-500 to get your 30-day free trial. You can get 1 free audiobook of your choice and 2 free Audible originals completely free. Yay! So yeah, thank you again to Audible for sponsoring this video. Now back to the acne chat. Second question was, how often do you have to go get blood work or go in for checkups? So for me, it was more heavy on the checkup period at the beginning of the whole process. So I think I had my first consultation December of 2018, And then I started taking Accutane January 2019. So the beginning of the year, last year, I was first on active Accutane at 30 milligrams. My doctor here in the UK was a lot more lenient and trusting of me. And I don't mean to say that to like call negligence or something like that, but he was just very like, I want to make sure that you're not pregnant, obviously. You have to sign something to say that you're using a couple forms of birth control, which is fine. And then you do your blood work to make sure that your liver is safe for the first month. And then the pregnancy tests for the first couple months as well to make sure that you're not pregnant. In the US, I found that the margin for error or the margin for grace or mercy as far as medical tests goes was non-existent. It was like, you have to get your blood work done. You have to have two clear pregnancy tests before you're even allowed to be given Accutane. And it was something where like the doctor didn't have authority to give me Accutane at any point. It was a separate system that was the worst thing ever. Oh my God, I can't even remember the name of it now because I've just like blocked it out of my head. It was so fucking annoying. But it was this like horrible system that you had to log into and answer questions about Accutane and answer questions about like fetal deformities and all this weird shit that men don't have to go through when they're taking Accutane in the US, but women do. And you had to have two clear pregnancy tests, which sucked because at the time I was in the UK when I first got prescribed and that wasn't an issue because I had a clear pregnancy test. But then when I went to the US and still wanted my prescription, I had to retake those pregnancy tests before they would give me a refill. So I had to wait 2 months in the US to even get Accutane. And by that point, I was like running out of Accutane that I had gotten from the UK. So like I was in between pills for like a week and a half. I just completely went off Accutane and like in the middle of, I think it was in the middle of February, I like ran out of my pills. And the doctor in the US couldn't even give me my Accutane because this whole like system doesn't let you pick up the prescription without like the computer checking it off that they've received pregnancy tests and stuff. It's just ridiculous. And I get it because it's for liability issues. They don't want people to get sued. But fuck that system. That was the worst system ever. You have to like pry open a pregnant woman's belly to like get your pill out. It's so stupid. Like it is archaic. It really does describe like the medical situation in the US. That's all I'm saying. And I know it's totally different depending on where you live. And I was talking to someone who is from Australia who watches my videos, which is very dope. She was on Accutane last year and like didn't seem to have any bad side effects or anything like that happen to her. So I think it just depends on where you are as far as blood tests and medical checkups go. I think it just depends on where you live, basically. Next question. Was there a point in your journey where the Accutane affected you so much to the point where you wanted to quit? And that is from @Rayzizel? Raisa? Risa? Risa? Thank you for your question. No, there was never a point where I was like, I'm not doing this anymore. Even when it was at its worst and my skin literally looked like a fresh corpse, I did not care. In fact, I loved it because it meant that something was happening. And I had heard this whole thing about like purging, like that's obviously a huge thing, is that sometimes in the first couple months of you being on Accutane, you can go through like the worst breakouts that you've had in your life. And that is exactly what happened to me. Like everything came to a head. It was painful. It was sore. It was bloody. Like my skin would just crack because isotretinoin Accutane is an overdose of vitamin E, which makes your skin so dry because it shuts down the oil production in your body. So that's why on really, really high doses, it can make like your joints hurt and like, you know, random stuff like that, because it's basically taking the lubrication out of your very oily body, right? Those parts were painful. I chafed my nipples real bad. That wasn't very nice. But overall, I would never say I wouldn't do it because I wanted to see results. And after the first couple months, when the purge started to go, I felt like I made the right decision. And to follow that up, what was the worst side effect you had? And that's from Bean Convene. That's cute. Beans. And she also had like the most amazing skin transformation on Twitter. If you want to see Accutane before and afters, you can go check out that thread on my Twitter. But your skin looks amazing. My lips were so dry, like the corners of my mouth would bleed constantly. Like if I smiled or laughed, like I was bleeding. And then I got really bad eczema on my hands and the sides of my face. Which I think was not helped by the fact that I was running a lot at the time. So even though I was wearing sunscreen and trying to moisturize and do all of that, I was still exposing myself to the elements. And so I don't think that really helped the whole eczema situation. But I regret nothing because my mental health stayed very stable that whole time because I was exercising and trying to keep myself active in some way. I didn't have the really horrible side effect of like a deep depression, which I know a lot of people can have. But just to address that, because I did see a lot of questions about that as well, it's something that I think is so personal. And like the reason for a depressive episode around Accutane, personally, I think it would be because if you're someone like me who had a really bad purge at the beginning, if something like your skin already makes you insecure, the idea of it being even worse and even more painful and even more obvious to the outside world would make anyone depressed, especially if it's already a depressive issue for you. So for me, it was one of those things where I think I very easily could have become depressed because of my skin if I allowed it to keep me indoors, to keep me from exercising, to keep me from my friends. I think I would have easily been depressed in that situation, but I knew that this was something that people go through. I knew that a depressive episode could come on. And so I started exercising really heavily, like 3 or 4 times a week, which isn't actually that heavy, but 3 or 4 times a week, like probably a month before I started taking Accutane, so that I would like already have that nice, you know, cushion of good chemicals in my brain, and then, you know, be able to ride that through whatever happened during my Accutane journey. So keep that in mind. If you're someone who is prone to depressive episodes, I definitely am. I didn't have that issue, but I also was kind of like actively combating it. And how long did the entire process take? And that's from Goliath Lisa. Thank you, Lisa, for your question. In total, from that December where I first got my recommendation to go on it from my dermatologist, and then that next January of 2019, from there, it was 6 months. So in total, 7 months of full Accutane process. And I would say that I saw results, which is one of the other questions I had. When in the process did you notice results? At Angie Guava. Thank you, Ange, for your question. I saw results probably, I think in March or April, I think April was when I started seeing like real results. If by results you mean like a negative result, then I started seeing that in January. And I probably went through 2.5 months of really, really terrible skin. And then in the third month, everything took a turn. So that was really awesome. I felt really good about that. And just to reiterate, not everyone goes through a crazy purge like I did. That same amazing Australian girl that I was talking about who went on Accutane, she was on 10 milligrams, which is like mind-blowing to me. I didn't even know you could go on that low of a dose. I thought 30 milligrams was low because my dermatologist in the US was like, you need to be on 70 grams. Like, that's what we recommend. And I was like, oh my God, my skull will fall off if I take 70 milligrams of Accutane. I've seen other people take that much. I would say that was one other thing is that in the US, they tried to medicate me really heavily. And in the UK, my dermatologist told me that there was no like substantial evidence that you needed to take that much Accutane to see good results. And I think that's actually why post Accutane, I have had no ill side effects that have stayed with me. Like I saw people talking about hair loss and their acne coming back right afterwards, like a lot of other stuff that I just haven't had an issue with. Like now it's almost February of 2020, which is crazy. So almost a year of when I was like in my full purge of Accutane, and I haven't had a single bad breakout, like none, no bad breakout or any kind of hair loss or any kind of like substantial issues post Accutane. And I think that really is because I didn't take such a high dose. So yeah, Just FYI, you don't have to take an insane dose to see like really good results. Another question that I got a lot on Twitter was, what did you use to prevent or heal acne scars? Oils, y'all. It sounds counterintuitive because you're drawing oils out of your body, so why would you put oils on top of it? But healthy oils are so good for healing acne scars or any kind of scarring. So I was on that rosehip game like crazy. I was using rosehip oil like every single day, especially when my skin was finally healing up. My dermatologist told me not to moisturize my skin at all. Like, he was like, if you are literally peeling like a lizard and bleeding and in pain, put a little bit of like Cetaphil on it. But overall, like, don't add any moisture to your skin. Like, just let it go through its process. And I had a really hard time doing that because I'm that moisturized bitch. Like, I need like an oil and a cream and like, you know, like a what would you call it? Like a waterbed on my face. You know what I mean? Like, I need the whole shebang. So I was like annoyed that I couldn't do it, but by the end of all of it, I was like kind of cheating a little bit and putting some rosehip oil on my face and putting Cetaphil on my face almost every day. So keep that in mind. That's pretty much what I use the entire time. But I seem to see that a lot in a lot of Accutane people, is that they don't end up having a whole lot of scarring by the end of it. And I feel like it's also because for whatever reason, Accutane makes your skin turn over so fast. Like, I can't even tell you. My skin was like peeling off my face all the time. Like, new layers of skin constantly peeling off my face. Same thing on my arms. I got insane like shedding of my skin on my legs. Like, I would exfoliate every single day and still have like flaky arms and flaky dry everything. So I think part of that too, there's something there where like, because there was so much cell turnover, it like almost didn't give it time to scar. I don't know if that has any logic to it, but it felt real at the time. So there you go. It was like I would get a little pot mark or something, and then like 2 or 3 days later, it would pretty much already be gone. So I don't know if that's the oil. I don't know if it was because I was trying to gently exfoliate, and by gently, I mean like very gently exfoliate, just to get like the residual dead skin off. Or if it was just like the drug itself that was moving my skin along so quickly that it didn't scar. But if you're someone who's looking to heal acne scarring or any kind of scarring, oils, rosehip oil. I'm trying to think of another one. I'm using like a little sample of a Sisley oil right now that I really like. I mix it with my foundation and it's like my favorite thing in the entire world. I'll show you. This is my little travel bag of makeup. Hello, I have this tiny, it is so like, oh honey, they were not gonna give me a full sample. This is Sicily, baby. They were not gonna give me too much of this. So this is like a tiny little sample of some Sicily oil that I got. And I mix it with my Beauty Counter Tint Skin. And this is already a hydrating foundation. So I add this in, mix it up, and I swear it makes my skin look amazing. Like, I'm wearing it right now. But it just makes me look so like hydrated and lovely. And I've noticed it really takes down like any kind of texture I have on my skin. So do that. Like when I was in the heat of Accutane and my skin was even drier than it is now, I would put an oil in my foundation like every single day if I was wearing foundation. Or I would just wear an oil alone because it just made my skin feel so much better. Like, I could actually like talk and move without it cracking and being awful. The other thing that I used a lot was the agave lip mask from Bite, which is amazing. So good for any kind of scarring or like wounds basically that you have on the sides of your mouth from it. And the other one, the Aquaphor healing ointment. That shit is legit, okay? Thank you, Megan Rinks, for telling me about that. That was one of the best things that I ever used. It was so good. I like still keep it in my purse because it's like the best lip balm other than the agave lip mask, which are, they're both very, very good. Have you broken out at all since being finished with Accutane? I'm gonna be done in 2 weeks and I'm afraid I'll break out again once I'm off of it. And that's from @Nicole. Thank you, Nicole, for your question. Okay, listen, the anxiety, the post-Accutane anxiety that you have of your acne coming back is so real. Like, I actually was like, hey, dermatologist, could I have a little extra Accutane just in case like something comes back up? And he was like, no, that's not how this works. You don't need that. Just go off of it and you'll be fine. And I was like, but what if it comes back? What if I have another breakout? Like, what if it just, I can't see you for a month? And like, what happens? I was so panicked when I went off of Accutane. I felt the exact same way. I wonder if everyone does after they come off Accutane. But the idea of having bad skin again, like, drove me crazy. I used to have dreams. Y'all, this is how messed up that whole process is. I got so like happy and excited that my skin was good because I just like didn't have to worry about it. Like, it wasn't a thought that I had in my head anymore. Next, and one of our last questions, thought this was kind of a weird one that I should answer. Hey girl, I want to go on it, but I've heard from several people Accutane makes your facial hair grow. I'm guessing you didn't have this experience, but do you know anything about it? And that's from I Purple Heart, Christina. Thank you, Christina, for your question. Well, I didn't have an issue with facial hair growth. And let me tell you, honey grows a pretty special little mustache every month that I get a little shave off or a little wax off if I'm feeling extra special. So I am not a stranger to facial hair, female body hair. It is just, not something that I had an issue with, for Accutane. I wonder if that has something to do with like oil production situation, you know, all of that. Maybe that's an issue that could arise. That might also be why people lose their hair on Accutane sometimes. It's just so personal. It is a drug that is, you know, very widely used by a lot of different people from every different walk of life. So it's going to be totally dependent on your body. But all I can say is the lower the dosage, the better in my head. If you can go lower, you mitigate a lot of these weird, crazy side effects that people have. I wouldn't really be worried about that aspect of it. And if you are worried about it, you can always go on it. And then if you start noticing side effects that are making you nervous or anxious, there is nothing wrong with you just stopping the medication. Like, I asked my doctor about that a million times because I was feeling the same way, where I was like, I really don't want there to be this like end-all be-all side effect that ruins my life. And he told me that it's not like another medication like an antidepressant where you need to wean yourself off of it. It's something that you can literally just stop taking one day. And then the last question I want to answer is from at Chalamet King. Yes, he is King. Danny, thank you for your question. For someone who's on a tight budget, which things would you say are the top most important in order to improve your skin? And she wrote like skincare products, food health items, medicine, vitamins, appointments with professionals. And just to be completely honest, I am one of those people that I am like, go to your doctor. Like, the best thing I did for myself was go to a dermatologist and find a dermatologist that really understood what I needed and what I wanted. And for me, I found that in the UK. So I went to probably like 4 or 5 dermatologists in LA, and I could just tell they were the type of doctors that saw a lot of me's walking in the room, and they were very used to just being like, okay, if you're not gonna go on Accutane, try Axone, try this benzoyl peroxide thing, try this salicylic acid thing, try this body wash, try this cream, try all these things, this antibiotic. But unless you were gonna do Accutane, they don't really know what to do to help you. It was really nice to go to a dermatologist in the UK who really was just stern with me and kind of firm with me and was like, if you're serious about getting rid of your acne, then you know that you need to go on Accutane. Like, you are a great candidate for Accutane. And I, like, after looking at your skin and hearing your history and looking at all your pictures, there's no reason for you to not go on Accutane. Go to the doctor. Number one, that's the best thing you can spend your money on, is finding someone who understands what you need. And also, you are saving money in the long run by going to see a professional who can help you out with this kind of stuff, rather than going online and trying a bunch of random things that are gonna end up costing you more money overall, even if they seem cheap at the time. Like, I can't tell you how much money I've probably spent on herbal tea, all right? I have probably spent like $100 on herbal teas that I've been told would cure me online, or like little weird, you know, vitamins that I thought would, you know, help my skin, or hormonal fixes that I thought would help my skin. I really wanted to fix my skin in a natural way and without Accutane or medication. And it just got to the point where like nothing that I was trying was actually working. So to me, that told me that if nothing is working and nothing ever did work, then it was worth just spending my money on a doctor that could tell me what to do. And listen, it's a very privileged position for me to be able to say, like, just go to a doctor, because, you know, for me, especially in the US, it was almost impossible for me to afford everything that came with Accutane and doctor's visits and all of that, because it wasn't covered by my insurance. I got super lucky that I basically got to use the NHS as a system here, and like not really worry about the whole like jacked up prices of medication in the US and all of that. Like, that's why this list is a little bit difficult, because I want to say spend your money on doctors and medication, but depending on the country you live, that's a very expensive cost. So in the UK, my Accutane was right around 30 to 35 pounds for my dose of Accutane every month. And in the US, it was at least $400 every month for my Accutane. And that's not with what I was paying for doctor's visits, because those weren't covered by my insurance either. After blood tests and everything, all of that was so expensive because it was all cosmetic. So I would say that in total in the US, to get one packet of Accutane, because ultimately I only took one packet of Accutane from the US, to get that one packet of Accutane, I probably spent like right around $1,500. Whereas in the UK, for my entire run, for my entire course of like 5 months of Accutane plus doctor's visits, I probably spent less than £500 in total on everything, which is still expensive, but if you're comparing it to the US, it was like nothing. I would take the UK side any day. I like actually genuinely do not understand how people pay for Accutane in the US. It is mind-blowing. Like, you have to save up for it. I don't get it. But you know what I will say? As far as skincare goes, I was using rosehip oil from Whole Foods, which was like $20, and the bottle lasted me 2 years. And then Cetaphil in a giant tub that I would put on my body and on my face that cost me £8. And I still have that. You can keep it for a year and a half, and it's almost been a year and a half, and it's not even gone yet. So those are pretty much the only two skincare products I've been using, other than like new testing oils and then a cleanser that I have from Drunk Elephant. But even that, I like didn't need to spend money on. Like, I could have bought any really soothing cleanser from Cetaphil and that would have worked just fine, or CeraVe, which is really, really good. So I would say, like, do not spend crazy amounts of money on skincare. You don't need to. Like, genuinely, you can find everything you need at the drugstore. My dermatologist told me, like, all the products that I needed to buy were all at the drugstore. So don't worry about that. Don't spend your money there. As far as food and health items go, like, obviously treat your body well and your skin will reflect that, unless you have like an actual severe medical issue in acne like I did. Like, if eating better makes your skin better, just eat better. I mean, I don't know. Yeah, spend your money on food if that seems to be the thing that helps your skin. Spend your money on medicine. Don't spend your money on vitamins. Vitamins are a crapshoot, especially in the US. None of it's regulated, so you don't even know what you're taking. All right. That is it for my questions, my answers to your questions. Thank you for asking them. Thank you for participating in this video. I appreciate all the questions that I got. And you made this video very easy to make, and now I've talked to myself for like 45 minutes, so I'm gonna stop now. But thank you so much. I'm glad to finally get this video out. Let me know if you have any more questions in the comments down below. I am very happy to sit when this video goes live and kind of answer through any questions you have. Once again, just disclaimer, I'm not trying to get you to take Accutane or take any medication. I'm just telling you my experience, which was an overwhelmingly positive experience. Like I said, it changed my life, and that's a hard bias to get past. So if it seems like I'm singing the praises of Accutane, it's because I had a very good run at it. But I think a lot of people have very negative runs of it too, so just keep that in mind. I saw every horror story, and I also saw every good story before I went on Accutane, and I decided to do it regardless of where I landed, which was probably gonna be somewhere in the middle, but it seems like I landed on the good side. So just keep that in mind when you're listening to me talking about it. And thank you once again for watching. And thank you again to Audible for sponsoring this video. On that note, I'm gonna go eat something because I'm hungry. So give this video a like if you liked it. Comment down below if you have any more questions, and I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye.